Okay, let's try this again, huh? I really hope this works this time. Because I'm getting tired of flying it. We're back. Welcome to San Antonio in the F-16. Heading towards... of all places, Lubbock. If the encoder gets overloaded at any point during this flight, I'm gonna be super mad. It just did, didn't it? Great.
San Antonio Tower, Duncan 11, ready at runway 4 East departure.
I guess we'll do what we can. Okay, fuel. Get us out of here. Jesus, the wind is coming directly from, like, this side, so that's fine. Encoding overload.
Duncan 11, continue for east departure. Duncan 11, leaving my airspace frequency change approved.
Still figuring this out, I guess.
San Antonio Tower, Duncan 11, frequency change.
How do you change the bit rate? How do you change your recording bit rate? Is it in the settings? Video. Common FPS value 60. Output. Audio bitrate is 160. Encoder preset is PS logo quality. What is that, P5? Audio bitrate of 2500 kbps. I don't know what the most optimum value for that is. So, okay. Super unprofessional. But then again, I'm not getting paid. we are about to go for a round-the-world trip. I might as well do this. It's super nonchalant. I've tried this flight like 6 times, and I say 6, it's more like 3. I've flown this route 3 times. So, you know, take that with a grain of salt. I'm a little annoyed. And I don't know how much power is left on my Oculus, so I don't think this is gonna actually get as far in as I want it to. rate seems fine now. Or better, at least. Also, I can't tell. Yeah, it seems to be fine. Seems to be doing fine. So here's the plan. I've done a round-the-world flight. It took me 50 hours. And I chose a very specific path last time because it was places that I had not been. But there were a lot of places that I left out. And I didn't record literally any of it because I couldn't figure this stuff out. So, now that I have to some degree figured out the recording situation, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the flight again. But this time, instead of taking the route that I did last time, I'm going to take a completely separate route. And hopefully I'll be done before my interview in an hour and 45 minutes. Which I didn't think I was going to have to say. I thought I'd be done with this already because I've done the flight twice today. This movement specifically is me looking at my computer screen through the gap between my nose and the Oculus. So, if I do that a lot, you'll know why. There are going to be a couple rules to this. I'm not going to be talking to AI, or ATC rather, very often. If I do, it'll be just because I feel like it. I'm also not going to be really worrying about fuel. I will have fuel enabled. I do have a button that, when you press it, refuels the aircraft midair. Also repairs. So, I won't be overly concerned about it, because I don't feel like that's the point of this. The point is to kind of just see the world. And, I will be keeping live weather on, pretty much. Because, in as much as I feel like a challenge is worth having for this with fuel, I also don't really care about that. But I do care about the idea of landing in difficult conditions. Excuse me. So. You know, if the weather is bad, we'll still try to land, maybe, you know, or have to skip to a next airport, and it'll make things a little more interesting. And yeah, fuel would help with that too, but I don't really care. We'll do our best, I guess. There are a ton of things that I've talked about in the previous versions of this video. One is that I'm looking forward to this flight because the last time I did this flight in the F-16, there were a lot of issues. It would pitch up violently past certain speeds when you just tap the control. It used to be some strange stall mechanic that I'm not aware of. I'm not aware if they've fixed that yet. These MFEs used to be touch and go there for a long time. And there was this gigantic, heat wave effect emitter that was present on some part of this aircraft. Towards the cockpit, and sometimes you would see it out the window and not really be able to see anything else. What the heck is going on? That's good to know. I really need to remember to bring the cursor back. Thank you, Microsoft. What was the other thing I wanted to talk about? This may, at some point, in some points during this flight, devolve into a small guided tour of the area. Because having lived in several places around the world, I do have memories of them, and I will be able to show you different aspects of where we're going. Like, you know, well, where's the chocolate museum in Cologne? Where's the, excuse me. My God. Where's the, where's Shakespeare's Globe? You know, I can show you those places in those respective cities. And doing that will be done via helicopter to via Cabri G2. I'm not quite done with my, you know, private pilot license for helicopters, but I do have a little bit of experience flying them, and I think that'll be fun. That will, of course, also be very heavily dependent upon the weather, because while the helicopter, or I'm sorry, while the F-16 can punch through a cloud like nobody's business, and it's almost as if it doesn't even exist. The Cabri G2 does actually care. Or at least my mastery of its controls cares. So. How are we doing? We're doing fine. 12 minutes in. Should be getting close, or I could be wrong completely. Oh yeah, no, wrong completely. Excellent. This is gonna be a long series of flights. The last time I did this, like I said, it took 50 hours. And the only way I was able to get through it was to fly like 2 hours a night, the max length of time that my stock battery on my Oculus could take. And it still took me an entire month to fly it. So, you know, different aspects of this might end up being a lot more boring. I'm going to spend quite a lot of it talking, probably, about whatever you guys want to talk about, if there anybody ever watches this. And, you know, if there are places that you want to specifically visit, or whatever, or see, I'm more than happy to fly through them. A lot of the more famous places in the world I've been to, like Tokyo, and Taiwan, and Paris, and London, and Cologne, as well as, like, Neuschwanstein, for example. So I can take you guys there. I know where they are. I've seen them before, in real life and here. So, yeah. Also, there are quite a few fun activities that I have planned throughout this flight, one of which is a, like, Top Gun flat hat mock loop route that I have planned out through the Alps, and I've done quite a lot of, so, you know, when we get to Europe, which may be 3/4 of the way through the flight. I'm intending on doing that in the F-18 because it is my favorite aircraft to do it in. So yeah, look forward to that. I guess I'll just pause sometimes too, you know, like we have probably a good 2 minutes left on this flight. This is like watching paint dry, Jesus Christ. Please, oh no, not the encoder. Come on, come on, go on, come on. Please don't do this to me. Still overloaded. Sweet. So none of this is coming through. It just, it's gonna look very patchy. Okay. Hold on a second. Okay. I've turned down the bitrate. No idea if that's going to help. But since it doesn't appear to be having any issues, we're gonna land this crap. I think I turned it down to 2000 bitrate. I think it was at 2500. And it really didn't need to be that high. Seeing as how I just want to land, we're gonna punch it. I'm gonna break this thing. Don't ask, I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, I probably could have figured out where the runway is from there. Last time. God damn it, the encoder is overloaded again? Are you serious? Hang on a second. We're gonna taxi a little bit. Okay, and we're back. I really hope that this holds. Because I'm getting really tired. Really? Okay, my bad. getting really tired of having to lower the bitrate. I don't know what a good bitrate is, though, so I'm sure... I'm sure that my knowledge of this is not working out properly. We're not getting any more errors about encoder overloading, so I guess this is fine. I have found the best option. Quest 2 battery is low. So, this is either the last flight or it's not. I mean, that's cool and all, but I can't see the runway even there, so... Watch me botch my first landing. Here we go. Encoder's not overloaded. We're good to go. I'm gonna end up watching this video afterwards too, just to make sure. But given the fact that I haven't gotten the error, and that error seems to occur only when the video's like bitrate drops so fast, or the frame rate of the video drops super fast, so. The fact that it's not there is a good thing, I think. Yeah, welcome to Lubbock. Last time I was here, it was snowing. And that was like 20 minutes ago, so... I wonder if it's still snowing. I know the traditional thing to do in the F-16 is to keep the nose up, but I'm getting a little impatient. And I don't care right now. You know, I think I might have caused somebody to go around. That doesn't seem safe. It doesn't appear to be snowing anymore. Well, I wonder what the wind looks like, because what am I doing? How about you don't die? Wing strike on an F-16, first time on the ground. Sorry, everybody. Ignore that. The problem is also that my rudder pedals are literally up against my chair and not in front of me at all, so I'm not used to it. Though that is a super excusey sounding statement. Don't see a windsock. Okay. We could just end it here, I guess. Yeah, I hope you guys join me for the next one. It may be great. It may be terrible. Who knows? Tune in, you know, in the next video to see if... I mean, even I don't know this, but we might try to do a helicopter flight. And take a little guided tour of Texas Tech. So... yeah. Have a great day, everybody.